Welcome back, folks. You're watching Sport Federation TV. It's great to have you along. We're, of course, talking about sport in the Western Cape, as you know, because you do watch Sport Federation TV every week here on Cape Town TV, DStv channel 263. Well, if you've been watching, you will know that we've spoken about equestrian sport on a number of occasions here on Federation TV. Of course, equestrian sport's one of South Africa's multi-coded structures, with gymkhana and show jumping and tent pegging. Tent pegging, in fact, being one of the topics that we're going to talk about tonight. And of course, you'll remember it was just a few weeks ago that we took a look in the equestrian sport at the Lipizzanos that's currently stabled at Mystico here in the Cape Winelands region. But in studio with me now is Gail Canovi. She's going to talk to us tonight about tent pegging. And she's going to tell us a little bit about what's happening at Mystico, where so many of the South Africa's national events end up. Gail, great to have you in studio.
Thank you very much.
You're obviously no stranger to TV.
Yeah, more or less.
Right, I mean, we're going to talk to you about, we would definitely want to find out more about Mystico, but before we go down that road, tent pegging. This is a word that most people don't understand. When you say to them tent pegging, they'll think it's something that you do when you go camping.
Yes, yeah, unfortunately it's not been... It's not a very well-known day-to-day sport, as you would do with show jumping and dressage. It's got its ancient origins, and what the name suggests is that's basically what it used to be. It used to be a cavalry event where basically during military occupations, guys on horseback will go, and they will actually go and spear out with a lance or a sword the tent pegs from the enemy camps, creating obviously tents falling over, creating a whole commotion. It's one of those strategies. Yeah, right. So it comes from a military background.
It seems to me that most of the equestrian sports actually come from a military background.
Yes, I think so, yes.
Yeah.
Definitely. I think horses has played quite a big role in the military. I mean, for ages. There is evidence that tent pegging actually originated about 500 BC. That's from where the first evidence could be found.
So you're telling me that you do tent pegging yourself. You seem to do it socially. Yeah. I think with you, we'd probably be wondering how many other of the codes you actually do socially as well. Probably all of them. Although when we spoke about the Lipizzanos just the other day, we did find out that you have to be highly qualified.
Yes.
To get on a Lipizzano stallion, but tent pegging itself, and you've got a big event coming up in August.
Yes. Look, with all equestrian sport, you have to be very proficient in your riding.
Yeah.
Obviously, that is ultimate safety. You can't go attempt to do any of these disciplines if you are not a very good rider, very well balanced, and you need to know exactly. The horse and yourself is a unity. So that's quite a thing. The World Cup that's coming up, it's actually going to be in August in George at the George Showgrounds,
right,
from the 23rd to the 26th of August. And it's
so this is the World Championship.
Yes.
The World Championship for tent pegging.
Yes.
I'm assuming countries all around the world coming down.
So there will be 9 countries participating,
right,
at this event. Qualifiers was held over the last couple of months, I would give it like about a year. So in total, there was 28 countries that took part in the qualifiers.
Right.
There is about 40 countries that's affiliated with international tent pegging. So worldwide, it is quite a big thing.
Who's the top country? Who's the best?
Well, South Africa used to reign supreme for many, many years. And at the last World Cup in 2018 and... was in Abu Dhabi. South Africa came second to Egypt. But yes, we've produced quite a lot of Protea riders, good athletes.
So from a South Africa perspective, I mean, there must be obviously a lot of logistics around this. Are the horses unique for tent pegging? I mean, it's not the same as your equitation and your gymkhana and your show. Different type of breed.
Yes, I would say the breed, preferably your boerpaard, your more placid horses. Because obviously you don't need to, like with show jumping, you've got horses that specifically are bred for that type of event. Where with tent pegging, you just need a nice, quiet, controllable horse.
That's where
the boerpaard has always been quite a versatile horse for all disciplines, but for tent pegging, that's the one that works the best.
For the World Tent Pegging Championships, I hope I've got that right, World Tent Pegging Championships then happening in George. What are you anticipating? How many days will it be happening? Will it be folks from around South Africa as well competing against the other countries?
Yes, there's 9 countries, of which South Africa is the one country that's participating.
How many do you expect there from South Africa? I suppose my question is, do you guys compete as a team or do you compete as individuals?
No, it will be as a team.
Right.
It's as a team. So your ITPF World Cup Championships are always, you always participate as the team.
Okay.
Yes, so your team points is that what I was actually then determine which country wins. You will obviously have individuals that will be recognized as the best rider during the World Championship and will be crowned the world number one rider.
Is there different age divisions in tent pegging, or is it a...
It's basically juniors and seniors. Juniors is under 21 and seniors above. Obviously, the seniors can be... When we participate in our provincial or interprovincial competitions, it's divided between supermasters, which is above 65, masters above 55, and then your seniors.
Great word, supermaster. Supermasters. Whoever came up with such a smart, the supermasters. Yeah. I mean, you would imagine being a master is pretty high above, but now you've got supermasters also.
Supermasters, yes. Yeah, so it's the youngest riders are normally, they start around about 6 years old. So as soon as they've mastered their riding skills and they can control a weapon, because your lance is an average between 2.1 and 2.4 meters long, and your sword. So as soon as they are able to control that safely, our youngest rider starts at 6 years old already.
Well, we're looking forward to it. So we're obviously hoping that South Africa is going to do well, and our Western Cape athletes are going to represent.
Yes, we've got one Western Cape rider, Johan Jordaan.
Yes.
So yes, he represents Western Cape.
Yeah. Anything on the calendar for Equestrian?
Next really big event is actually the Dressage South African Championships, the Adult Dressage Champs. That is going to be in September at Mystico. We have got a couple of smaller events, and then, referring to the Lipizzaners, they have got every first Sunday of the month.
Okay.
Do have a show at Mystico for people to attend. And
that's open to the public?
Yeah, that's open to the public. They sell the tickets at the gate as well as, obviously, online. And then, another big thing on our calendar every end of the year, around about November, is what we call
the Chairman's Cup.
The Mystico's Indoor. Indoor.
I'm busy catching up with
the Indoor Grand Prix.
The Indoor Grand Prix.
Indoor Grand Prix.
Right,
so that's also run as a national event with the riders ranking, getting ranking points. Which makes that one quite popular is the prize money is quite substantial. The sponsorship is quite substantial. We're in the unfortunate position that a lot of times you battle to get sponsorships. One or two of your shows a year, you actually pull the rabbit out the hat.
Everybody battles with sponsorship. Yeah. I think that's how it is. I'm sure that Jackie Nichols, your chairperson, and Sylvia Bruckner, your former chairperson, are working hard at making sure that equestrian sports keeps doing so well, as you have been. Equestrian sports has really been fantastic in the province. Gail, we're going to say thank you to you for coming in.
Pleasure.
Can't wait to find out and see what happens then at the Tent Pegging World Cup. Happening, of course, in George, right?
Yeah.
In August. And will you be competing?
No, unfortunately not.
But you'll be supporting.
So thanks
for coming in, and we're looking forward to catching up again soon.
Okay, thank you very much.
There we go, folks. Western Cape Equestrian, of course, shining again. And in this case, it's tent pegging. So there you have it, an open invitation to go and watch the Tent Pegging World Championships happening, or World Cup happening in August in George, which is very exciting. And remember, get down to Mystico and go and watch the Lipizzaners. You'll be absolutely thrilled. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll carry on talking sport. Don't go away.